When you're working with a client, don't you just want them to go somewhere that they can really understand and that helps them understand what you have going on with your customer relationship? Whether you're an agency or you're working with a client in any sort of capacity, Softr has an amazing client portal template that'll solve all of your client portal needs. Many businesses are looking for a way to securely share information with their customers or clients without needing to communicate by an email. And when you're looking for something along those lines, you're going to want to use a client portal. And that's why we have it. Because a client portal is an amazing option for a web app that can be accessed via a secure entry point with a login where users like your clients and your employees can go through and see all of the specific goodness and information extremely easily. If I click on preview here, I can see how the client portal template has an awesome overview of what it would look like to see the entire portal. If I press that, I can see it from a few different views, whether it be the admin, client, or consultant. If I was a client and I clicked on the magic link here, just like you can do with any of our other templates in Softr, I can see all the different statuses of the projects that I have going on, as well as being able to filter them between planned, in progress, and finished projects. And then if I want more information on them, I can click on the project right there, and then it will showcase some of the baseline information as well as who is working on it. And furthering that, I will also be able to see the tasks associated to it and their statuses in a little board view here, whether it's in progress, done, or not started. And then if I want more information on the team members, I can just click on them really quick and it will showcase, okay, this is a client's email and phone number associated with that client. Then when it comes to invoices, I also will be able to track whether there is paid or open invoices. So for example, influencer marketing, there was a $7,500 invoice that was due in February for what project. And then if I click on it, I can download the invoice as well and save it for my records later. Good old taxes, very fun. And that's definitely not the only view we can see here. After I log out, I can then take a look at the portals from a consultant point of view. So a consultant would be someone like you who would be able to see all the different projects. And then I can also see this from a consultant point of view. And in this case, I'm only going to have access to the different projects that are associated to me. And last but not least, we have our good old fashioned admin. And our admin is going to be the one that has access to everything and is going to have access to all the different projects across consultants, clients, has the view of all of the different clients, as you can see right here. And then if I click into one of them, I'm gonna have more context as to not only the clients, but who the specific contacts are at these clients' companies. And then last but not least, I will also be able to see the consultants and learn more about them by clicking on them and seeing what projects they are assigned, and the different statuses can be filtered through, just like we had in the main projects view. And then last but not least, from the admin point of view, being able to see all of the different invoices is going to be convenient across all the different clients. Now, in order to make this template, all I'm gonna do is press use template. I then can just connect it to a data source. I'm gonna pick Airtable, then copy the base to my Airtable account, add the base, and then last but not least, create my application. And you can see that in the back end, we have all the different views of the different headers based on who you are. So just hovering over these, you can see visible to admins has all these, visible to consultants has just that, visible to clients has just that. Now you may be asking, how the heck am I able to see just the projects that are associated to me? By going to this projects page, you'll see that this My Project system is set up with a conditional filter, where the client is logged in user's client, or the assignee email is one of, and then the logged in user's email. So this just means in any circumstance, whether you're the client or whatever logged in user you are, that the associated projects will show up on this projects page. And that exact same thing ends up happening when it comes to the invoices. On the invoices page, we have the same filtering setup so that the logged in user is just gonna see whatever clients are associated to them in this invoices page. Now, what I would do here is have an actions option for adding a top bar button that would add a record. And in this circumstance, I can add a record to map to the different properties that make sense, like the invoice name or the file for the specific invoice, like this right here, so that when I'm interacting with this and I have all of these different fields mapped, what I then can do is have it filtered so that for the button visibility, only clients can, for example, do an ad record. And this is gonna be based off of visibility here. So you can see that this is filtered already to the clients from a user group standpoint. So if I remove that, I then could change it so that this button visibility to add invoices could be just for admins or clients or both, so that both of them are able to add different invoices to this section, mattering on their different needs. The same can go for the projects and project details. Adding different things like the ability to add an action button or even an item button that would do one click update. And then, for example, could change the project status, replace existing value with something else, or the assignee to logged in user and then email. So let's say, for example, you wanted to just have a one click option for updating new assignee. That could be an option, or more accurately, not just you, new assignee, but assign me. And then in the same breath, if we were to go to something like the project details page, we could add options for there to be an action button and then edit the record with different things like the project image, name, the client, the status of the project, and other options without you needing to go into Airtable and change this actual data. These are the kind of ways that I want you to start thinking about how you can improve on things like this client portal, which are awesome, but every single template is not going to be exactly suited towards your needs. We're just giving you a baseline for getting started in your software journey with things like this client portal in order to help you out as best as we can. I personally love mixing and matching my own preferences with the different templates that we have here at Softr, because then my needs are met. And I already had a really pretty base to start from. Shout out to the team at Softr for building out these templates all the time and for making things like this amazing client portal in order to help us manage all of our client information in one simple and awesome place. I'd also like to thank you for checking out this video on how to improve your different Softr skills even more.